fashion, fast cars and faster ladies. Thankfully, they take no notice of the moralists and with the new album Stay Sick, prove again that the devil has all the good music. Lux Interior, Poison Ivy, Nick Knox and Candy Del Mar play mangled punk R&B with tongues firmly in cheeks and no concessions to good taste. You want to see the essence of Cramp?
The world's most notorious cult band and rockabilly fiends, the Cramps, are back. Lux Interior and soulmate Poison Ivy started the band in 1976. Heavily influenced by original rockabilly agents like Screamin' Jay Hawkins and Ricky Nelson, and a fixation with all things trashy, they developed their own uniquely mutant strain of rock and roll. In no time, they outdrew every punk band playing the club scene in New York and recorded their first album, Songs the Lord Taught Us, in Memphis.
What inspires you in life generally?
Sex and horror.
Yeah, sex and horror.
And two big ones.
Main music, you know, blues music, rockabilly, old R&B, you know, 60s music too, kind of up to the R&B point before it got too psychedelic. Any just raw, stomping, primitive rock and roll. And movies, I guess, as far as I look, even just old, we collect a lot of old things. I don't know why.
The Cramps have released more sex music for rockabilly souls with their seventh album, Stay Sick. The new single is Bikini Girls with Machine Guns and is getting the kind of promotion that spells crossover and a wider audience. Now, could this mean the Cramps will lose their underground status?
We never wanted to be a cult band. We think a true rock and roll band, you know. Any of those hillbillies making music in the South at Sun Studios back, you know, in 1954, they didn't want to be cult figures, you know. They might have only sold 500 records or something, but they wanted to have a number one hit. We want to have that power and see it, because we'll know what to do with it if we get it, you know.
Song titles like All Women Are Bad and Can Your Pussy Do the Dog, it does not come as a surprise that the Cramps have been accused of being sexist.
I think one of the things that makes rock and roll a great thing is it separates the squares from the cool people. And I think there are some of our fans that realize what we're doing can see past a title like that. That title in particular, All Women Are Bad, was aimed at the people that were criticizing us. We say, okay, you call us sexist, we'll show you sexism, you know. But it's a tongue-in-cheek thing, you know. It's like we'll attack anything on two legs or four legs or whatever, you know. I just think there's no more feminist band in the world than the Cramps.
Right now is plagued by minority groups demanding record censorship. The records under attack would have stickers saying they are not to be sold to minors. Some heavy metal and rap bands are under observation, as are bands like the Cramps.
When rock and roll came out in the 50s, there were like hot-headed preachers saying rock and roll breeds VD, it's jungle music, this and that. And that was considered goofy at the time. And I think this is worse now. I mean, at least there weren't laws against it preventing it. People could do what they wanted. This is the first time in America there's been laws preventing self-expression.
With the squeaky clean face of new music represented by Kylie and New Kids on the Block, can we fear that real roots rock and roll is dead?
Rock and roll, it never was a trend like acid house or calypso or, you know, cha-cha-cha. Rock and roll was a bigger thing, but it's a recent thing, so people haven't taken it as seriously as that. You know, it's here to stay.